Привіт, I'm Tyra from Ukraine and welcome to my channel again. In this episode I will show you Dnipro. Mentioned in my live stream that I wanna do the tour in Ukraine. I wanna do this special for my blog, and I already told that I accept donations, but I have such circumstances that I need to do some business here, and I decided why not to show you Dnipro since I have a time. I want to start with this hall. You enter here and you already can see the living room. It looks like this. Here you can see the kitchen. It's like the apartment studio. I lived by myself here, so it was more than enough. The view is like this. You see the main road. Honestly, people who are sensitive to noise, I wouldn't recommend to stay somewhere here, because at night you can hear the cars. The bathroom is pretty big. Here is the huge mirror, and what is advantage, it's this huge bathtub that was very cool and awesome. This is pinky bedroom, interesting rose pictures. Looks empty, but that was really enough for me. You don't need to worry about the safety because the building is like the round, and you will have special keys, and only people who have the same keys with you can enter to the territory. Right now, guys, I'm in a cafe where you will have breakfast in Dnipro. I'm with Valentina.
Hello, guys. Yes, it's really a nice place to have a breakfast. Everything is very tasty, but only one little problem they have, that menu only in Russian. So you will come here with your personal assistant and she will help you to make your choice.
So they have breakfast, waffles, pies, different kind of salads, sandwiches. For example, let's see that oatmeal cost around $2.
Food in this place is only healthy and organic. I ordered tea pudding.
And I ordered cheesecake pancakes. What is it called? Like, it's made out of cottage cheese, eggs, and you fry it.
Transport that people use here, it's a tram. Post for Grimnia.
It's really easy to use because only one train work in Dnipro City.
Oh, okay.
So you can go one way or another way.
And the subway is super easy because only one line.
Yes, the same. Yes. One line and three stops.
Cool.
Guys, I just noticed. Did you notice it too? You can pay by card in a tram. Wow, that's super technology in Ukraine. And there's some sign in Dutch or German. Let me know what it is about. Guess what I'm going to do now? Here is the token. Here is the, what's this, safe? I will put my luggage. So I put the token and put any number I want. This is main Dnipro train station. When you go outside, you see the main restaurant of Ukraine, Pozata Chata. Anyway, I've told that recently they started reconstruction, so you can see nice architecture around yourself. Valentina, life hack from you.
So guys, if you need to change some money here in Dnipro, so rate in near train station is much more better than in the center of the city. Do it here.
This is the biggest flag of Ukraine in whole country.
It was established in this year. Historical Museum. Valentina does not recommend.
Really? If you want to see Old Spoon, you can come to our historical museum, but it's not interesting at all.
Unfortunately, our Kyiv museum is bigger, but your looks pretty interesting, like architecture. Right now we're situated at the modern museum dedicated to modern war. You can see a lot of cars that are brought recently from that war and a lot of other stuff. Here you can see we went inside. It seems to be for free. I don't know. No one asked us. I don't see a cash desk. As a person who lives in Dnipro, you know everything here and tell me, is it a dangerous city? A lot of people are afraid that it's close to war area.
Dnipro city is 100% safe city. You can walk around, you can see that no war in Dnipro city. Of course, it's only 250 kilometers from the war, from Donetsk. A lot of people from Donetsk come and move to Dnipro and now living here.
Are you worried that it can come to your city, the war?
You know that it will not happen already. When it started, of course, everybody worried. All the Ukraine was worried about it. But now we know that nobody come to Dnipro. Because I think that because in Dnipro is a huge Jewish community and the biggest Jewish center in Dnipro city, biggest in Europe. Actually, I think no, because our government make money with this war, so that's why it's not necessary to stop war with Russia. As in each city, you can find Park Shevchenko. I think each city has the same name of park. It's most popular and most biggest park in Dnipro city. Very beautiful because it's situated in the island.
Wow! You have installed the chess table, very convenient. Мне кажется, такое в каждом городе, но просто именно такой шаховой аллеи нема. Так. Привет. Привет. Show you the Jewish complex. It has hotel, restaurant and synagogue. It is called Golden Rose and I know a lot of Jewish people come to Dnipro to see it. Right now I'm at a famous place that called Katerinoslavsky Boulevard. I called it an Instagram place because it looks very modern with modern shops and restaurants. Looks very clean and neat, unlike some other parts of the city. I want to tell you that I'm preparing with Valentina a dating tour. We call them romantic adventures, and all the video and details will be soon. I hope. Thank you.
for your time. Thank you for watching this video. I didn't have a lot of time to see Old Dnipro, but I'm sure I will come back and show you more. I hope you really enjoyed it. See you soon. Bye.